Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and I'm talking to a lot of people recently about Power BI, and people are like, hey Patrick, you and Adam talk about star schemas, you talk about DAX, you talk about Power Query, from coming from Excel to Power BI, do I need to do all these things before I can use Power BI? I'm like, no, you don't. Power BI is easy, and there's like, show me, and I'm like, stay tuned. If you're finding this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. People are talking about Power BI. The world is talking about Power BI, but there's still some people that's like, man, Power BI is hard. It's so hard to get started, especially with all the stuff that Adam and I are spewing out of our mouth about star schemas and data silos and DAX, data analytic expressions, and Power Query and all these different things. And they're like, well, do I need to know all this stuff just to do Power BI? No, you don't. You can actually get started with Power BI rather easy. And in this video, I want to show all the people that are new to Power BI, that's thinking about using Power BI, the people that's coming over from Excel, right? The mighty Excel, and they just want to use Power BI. I'm going to show you how you can easily do it without any of that stuff. Just a couple of clicks, you have a beautiful report. All right. So you guys know how I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Once you download and install Power BI and open it for the first time, you can sign in or you cannot sign in, but there's these little options right here that's just on the back of the very first page before you do anything. You can import data from Excel, because we all have data in Excel, from SQL Server. You can actually paste data, or you can try some sample data. And I'm wondering how many people have actually clicked that button, try sample data. If you're just getting started with Power BI, or if you know someone that just wants to get started with Power BI, once they click that button, they're gonna get a couple of choices. There's a tutorial that you can go and walk through, and it's a great tutorial, but I'm about to take that tutorial to the next level. So if you know some people that want to get started, you should share this video with them. When you click this button, you get a little option right here, and you can say launch a tutorial for everyone that just wants to go walk through the tutorial and do a lot of reading, go do it. Or you can follow along with this video. So go ahead and click load sample. So when I click load sample, basically what it's gonna do is it's gonna pull some data and it's gonna say, hey, Patrick, which one do you want? And obviously my brain goes to financials, but honestly, you could choose either one. If you click this one, you'll see the data. Financials, if you choose sheet, you'll see the data. Let's go ahead and choose financials because it has a name. And so if I'm just getting started with Power BI, I'm really tempted to click this gold load button. Don't do it, because I want to just kind of introduce you to the query editor. Go ahead and click transform data. Now you see the data that's brought in from that table in Excel, and there's lots of information here. Take a look at it. So I'm going to collapse this. The first thing that I immediately see is that I have some decimals on units sold, and I really don't care about it. How do I change the data type? It's so easy. If you just click this right here, right? We don't have to search anywhere in the ribbon. If you just click that item right there, I can switch this over to whole number. Yes, go ahead and replace current, and it completely gets rid of the decimal place. Just like that, just a couple of clicks of the button. I start looking at some other things, and I see this none. Maybe I don't want to report on this none. So let's filter out some data. Just like Excel, click the little drop down to filter some stuff out, uncheck none, and boom, just like that, I filtered some stuff out. What's brilliant about this, I did say brilliant, is that Power BI is tracking all these steps. And if I don't want something, if I want to undo something, I can click the X right here, or I can click the gear, watch this gear, and I can change the filter. Maybe I don't want none. Maybe I want to change it to low or high or something like that. Then maybe I have these extra columns. I already have a date. Why do I need month, month name, and year? I can right click and choose remove, or I can choose a column and press delete, or I can go over here and choose columns and just uncheck the ones that I don't want. Boom, just like that. The flexibility, the possibilities in Power BI, they're all right there. Guess where? At your fingertips, okay? After I prep my data up, there's a little button in the top left corner called close and apply. If you click it, there's a couple of things you can do. If I click close, it's not gonna apply all the transformation, all the data prep that I've done. If I click apply, it's gonna apply them, but not close this window. If I click close and apply, duh, it's gonna do exactly what I wanted to do. It's gonna close that window and then suck all that data in, and create a nice data model for me. So once I've prepped all my data up, now it's time to build a beautiful report. You don't have to do a whole bunch of work. If you know your data is at the state you want in your Excel file or your CSV file, you just pull it in, right? Just pull it in the Power BI like I've done. Over here in the fields list, I can see all my columns. There's so much information here. If you just take a look, there is a sigma symbol or a summation symbol right here. This means that if I use this, Power BI is gonna add it up for me, okay? There's a date right here. If I expand that date out, Power BI has a built-in functionality that builds a nice date hierarchy for me. When we wanna talk about self-service, this is self-service. You know, if I'm just trying to do some quick analysis of some data and I wanna share it out with a few people, Power BI is the tool for you. I kind of know what I want to do. I want to build a profit analysis, segment profit analysis. So what you can do is if you go to insert, choose text box, watch this, segment profit analysis. And I'm going to make this bold and then I'm going to right align it and I'm going to increase the font. So let's increase the font to about 36. And now there's the title of my report. And then what I want to do is I want to filter the report by a few things, particularly year. So if I click year, it's going to go ahead and create a nice table. There's a visualization pane that contains all types of visuals. I'm going to choose a slicer. I don't know anything about designing Power BI reports, but check this out. Just like that, I've created my first filter, on page filter called a slicer. I'm going to copy this and paste it. And then guess what I'm going to do? Watch how easy it is. I want to filter by segment also. I'm going to drop that right there, get rid of that. And now I have these on-screen filters for year and segment. So now I want to start building some stuff. What I'm really interested in is my total profits because Power BI is aggregate aware. Click in the white space, click one of these fields. Guess what it's going to do? It's going to automatically aggregate it and create a nice little bar chart for me. But I actually want to see the number. In that case, all I would do is go over to the visualization pane and use the card visual and boom, just like that. I know how much profit we've made all up. If I click the format icon over here, I can choose data label and say, don't format this. I want to see all the numbers. And then I want to reduce the size. Look how flexible this is. And then what I'd like to do is put a dollar sign on this. So if I choose that column and then I go over to my formatting, click the dollar sign, and then you're going to see that it converts it to currency, but then poof, look at all those decimal places. Let's change it. Easy. Boom. Two decimal places. And then what I'm going to do is go back to the format, turn on title, turn off category, and this is just my total sales amount. Center this, change the font color to white, change the background color to blue. And now I got something really nice that we're taking a peek at right here. Now, just do a little format because I like the drop shadow with Power BI. I don't know if you've been paying attention, but how much code have I written? Not much, not much. I'm just dragging and dropping. And that's the beauty of Power BI. For anyone that wants to do some quick analysis, this is the way to go. So now I'm gonna copy and paste this. Simple as that, copy, paste. Wait a minute, I changed this total sales amount. I meant to name that total profit. My bad, because I actually dragged total profit there instead of total sales amount. It's okay, because Power BI is flexible. Watch this, I'm gonna change this to total profit. Boom, that one's profit. And then I'm gonna click this element right here, go ahead and grab the sales amount field and drop it over profit. And boom, it replaces it. Now I will need to do the same formatting that I did for profit. Boom and boom, same thing, just works. So that's my profit, that's my sales. I sold a lot, but I didn't make a lot. It's okay. I wanna get more detail. So I love to see a map to see where things are coming from. I do have a country field. If I click in the white space, choose country, guess what country is gonna do automatically for me? It's gonna create a nice map. Look at that. I didn't do anything. I didn't tell Power BI to do anything. It just did it for me. Then I'm going to take profit, drag it over to the size of the bubbles. And now I can see where I'm making some money. The cross highlighting is amazing. So if I click this, it actually filters all the elements on the page down just to that. So far, I'm just learning the clicks. If you're new to Power BI, you don't have any data, you can use this to just suck that data in. So now I have this, you know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go here, and then I'm gonna go to my format icon, and I'm gonna turn on my drop shadow. There's a nice little feature built directly into the map. If you click this, you can actually, you know, like lasso a couple of these together, and it's actually multi-selecting so I can see what it's filtering. So now what I'd like to do is create a quick bar chart that shows me the top three products. I don't quite know how to do that. How would I do that? Well, watch this. Double click on the canvas. And then what I'm gonna do is type top three products by profit. And you can see there's my top three products. I didn't do anything. All I did was type, give me the top three products. Boom, just like that. There's my top three products. And all I did was ask Power BI a question. Guess what else I'm gonna do? Turn on my drop shadow. And then what I like is a line chart to show me profitability. So I click right here, add my line chart, line it up, and I wanna look at it by month. So I go over here, choose month, because I have my automatic hierarchy. I don't have to create a date table. Drop month here and look at my profitability, drop it onto my values, and boom. I share this out with someone and they go, Patrick, you know what we would like? We would like to see gross profit margin. And I go, I think that's gonna require me to use that DAX stuff. No, you don't. No, you don't. Watch this. We're gonna go here, right click, and we're gonna use new quick measure. I asked him, I was like, well, what's the formula for this gross profit? And they go, it's net sales minus cost of goods sold divided by net sales. I'm like, okay, got it. I can use these quick measures. And if you go to the bottom, nobody probably uses these, but it's subtraction. So I'm gonna say subtract the base value, which is my net sales, the sum of my net sales from my cost of goods sold. And that'll give me my gross profit. Still not writing any code, just all drag and drop. So if you click that measure, I can rename it. Or I can simply go here and choose rename. Up to you. So we're gonna call this one gross profit. But we want the margin, we want the percent. That's easy. Right click, new quick measure. So I'm gonna go to divide, right? So I'm gonna take my gross profit divided by sales and click okay. And then what we're gonna do is click this guy and we're gonna choose rename gross profit margin. And then I'll click it and then I'm gonna go over to the measure tools, make it a percent, go back to this line chart right here. I'm gonna make it a bar chart because somebody asked me something really interesting. I'm gonna get rid of profit. I'm gonna bring in my gross profit margin. And so they said, hey Patrick, can we conditionally format this? Can we make the lowest point red and the highest point, they could be whatever they want. I wanna show this on a line chart. And I was like, sure you can. So we go here, choose format, choose data colors, and you'll see this little conditional function button here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna say, go here, choose my gross profit margin. And then we're gonna say our lowest value is red, our highest value can stay blue. Click okay, and you go, Patrick, you just created a rainbow, but watch this. The lowest value is red, but they want a line chart. Go right here, boom, just like that. Just like that, we'll expand this out a little bit. And you can see the lowest point is red, and that's the one I'm really interested in. If I start choose 2014, you can see how it changes. If I choose my slicer, everything's working. I haven't written any code, and they go, okay, Patrick, I just noticed that total profit has parentheses around it. Can we make that red when it's negative? Of course you can. So we're gonna click this guy right here. Again, go to data labels, use my conditional button here. You can see sum of profit. We're gonna change this to rules, so easy. If it's greater than or equal to one, and all you gotta do is empty this one out. Just empty the minimum out because we don't care about the minimum, make it black. And then we're gonna add new rule and we're gonna say if it's less than or equal to zero, make it red. Click okay. Boom. So if I toggle between these two, black, red, there's all my conditional stuff. No code, no star schema, no date table, no advanced Power Query, just clicking, clicking, clicking. All right, let me wrap this up. So then they go, and okay, Patrick, this is cute, but what I like is a summary. I'd like to have a summary of this chart right here. And I'm like, okay, well, let's do a little formatting on our report. Let's do a little formatting. So we're gonna take our map, squish our map in a little bit, expand this out. I'm gonna copy this line chart, kind of shrink it a little bit, and then I'm gonna use my smart narrative visual. And now I get a nice summary at 0.6% negative point. December had the highest gross profit, right? It's great. And if I choose channel partners, this text updates, but watch this. So I'm gonna do this, and I'm gonna say profit analysis summary, select that. I'm gonna bold it, underline it, increase this a little bit. And now then I'm going to delete that because that was a complete accident, but I'm gonna choose all of that text and increase this to about 12. And just like that, with a few clicks, I've just built a beautiful dashboard with a summary, with some Q&A, with some deep analytics and filters and slices without writing any code, just using some data from Excel with a few clicks, with some quick measures, and now I've produced this beautiful dashboard. All right, what do you guys think? You got any questions, comments? Do you have friends or people you know that's trying to get started with Power BI and they go, oh, it's so hard. You got these Excel friends that go, oh, Excel is so much easier. I beg to differ. I love to know, right? Let's continue the conversation where? In the comments below. It's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel. Hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.